Damn, dude. I haven't seen you since last year.
Oh my god! Oh jeez, oh my god!
Hello everyone, welcome to my 2021 year review, where I reflect and talk about every major thing that's happened this year. Just quite a lot of stuff to cover, because this was a very nice year. I mean, despite its ups and downs, a lot has changed about me. I've met some really great people, and I couldn't imagine where I'd be without them now. And some people, well...
I wish I'd never even known you existed.
Now. Following the end of 2020, we lost our beloved Flash games, the magnificent creation that gave a lot of us our childhoods. I was playing all the ones I played as a kid back in the day, for one last time. Mario Kombat, Raft Wars, Totem Destroyer 2, Skull Kid, Electric Man 2, and my personal favorites, Dad and Me and Final Ninja. We don't talk much about Final Ninja Zero, but Final Ninja, arguably my favorite of them all. The Flash game I revisited the most, the gameplay, the music, I just love everything about it. And now, it's gone. After the ball had dropped, it was over. I was a bit sad, honestly, knowing they were gone forever. And as I watched the ball drop from home, I already felt like this year was cursed. It didn't even feel like 10 seconds later, but I was already in a big fight with my brother. Like, it was brutal. Anyway, a few days later, fresh new start into the year. I got Catman in Battle Cats, which is an Uber I'd wanted for so long, and I'd finally gotten him. I was bouncing up and down like a maniac with joy. I was very happy about that. Then sometime before January ended, I had watched my good friend Jaymon stream this game called Friday Night Funkin' quite a lot. At first, I hardly had any interest and didn't know much about the game. It didn't really seem that interesting at first, but then something had just kicked in, and now I'm just hooked to the music and mods that have come from the game. I don't play the game that much, but I just love the music, really. Then come February, Valentine's Day had come around. I was still with my ex, and we had a great day together, after not being able to hang out in so long because of her strict parents. That was really about it in February. There's nothing else that even happened. Not that I recall, anyway. Then by March, my birthday came around, and last year had been totally ruined by COVID. No one was allowed to come over at all. This year, I at least had my boy Sully, my ex again, and Serenity. And on my 16th birthday this year, I'd gotten one of the best gifts ever that I still love and appreciate very much. It's from my mom a couple days after my birthday, a Battlecat-styled poncho. I've worn it at every opportunity I can around the house whenever I'm clean. Even to this day, just because I really, really like it a lot. I don't care what anyone says, I will wear my blanket 24/7 whenever I want and look like a small child. You can't tell me otherwise. I'd also received a game I wanted for a long while, Batman Arkham Knight, and a couple days later as a late birthday gift, the Among Us Airship update had finally dropped, coming early 2021. Yeah, more like just before. It's mid-2021, so it still counts as early 2021. Whatever. We all know it took a while for it to come out, but it finally did, and that was hype. A lot of fun memories were made the first day Airship came out, and there was also the shadow bug. Oh, that was so funny. Shadows being glitched, and you could see through walls. It was a fun time the first day on Airship, but also never forget what also resulted from a little bit after. April 2nd, I was away from home and pretty bored. So I thought, hey, why not some Airship Among Us? And that's what I did. After getting banned immediately for some reason in three different lobbies, I landed upon Chibi Zuzu, the most wholesome and fun lobby I'd encountered in pubs in a really long time. I've made content in the past about wholesome Among Us lobbies, and like 80% of those lobbies I had sadly never recorded. But even though this was one of the 80% I hadn't recorded, I was still happy that I landed upon this lobby anyway. I had tons of fun, and after it's time to leave and finally go home, I got the owner's Discord username. We added each other, inviting each other to our servers, and from that day on, my life was changed forever. I found myself in the Creation Kingdom, meeting the most interesting, fun, bright, creative, and loveliest people I had ever met before. I couldn't imagine not playing that day or not ever encountering them. These people, along with the help of my art teacher, had actually inspired me to like drawing and doing art again. Because all my art teachers from years before, Not gonna lie, they made me hate drawing and doing any kind of art because they were harsh the way they treated me. Just because of my imperfections and feeling I could never be good or do it right at all. They made me think that you have to be perfect when you're doing art. Yeah, thanks to Croatian Crew and Miss Nason, who ended up being my 10th grade art teacher, I've come a long way and learned a lot in art. Drawing has become my new addiction, you could say, at this point. The very first time that I had voice calls with Zuzu and the gang was pretty nerve-wracking. However, the more time I had spent in voice calls with these people and the more I played, the more comfortable I had become, and the closer I had felt to them. As time went on, I started getting used to them and knowing them even better. I felt pretty great. And at the time, my ex used to tell me about how she wanted to watch anime badly. She finally started a series called My Hero Academia. I don't know if you've heard of it, but, like, from what I hear, it's cringe. I don't know. Like what you like, but I hear a lot of backlash about it. I'm not really interested in it myself, but it exists, that's all I could say. I don't remember exactly how, but all of a sudden, me and her were nicknaming each other based off Deku and Bakugo from the show. I was calling her Teddy, and she was calling me Puppy, and I kinda liked it at the time. Me and her start doing some roleplays, just pretending to be a pup and a teddy bear. Just being a wholesome, lovely couple that we were at the time. I started questioning if I was a furry at this point. I sure was kinda acting like one, and I liked the idea of being a furry. And also, since I was within a community of furries and bronies, it was pretty much inevitable that I'd been furritized on May 31st. And I officially accept myself becoming a furry that day on. I got a warm welcome into the community, and yeah, from that day on, I am furry. I am Wolfie. And fast forwarding a bit, the end of hybrid school year is coming up and summer is finally going to come around. And I can do as I want without school in the way. Oh. What's this? June 11th, my ex came to me in messages and left a hole in my heart, telling me how she doesn't have feelings for me anymore and wanted to break up. All the love we shared together, talking about being together forever in the future. It all seemed fake now. I thought we both had the same idea. I thought we both had the same fantasies. I thought we cared, but I almost couldn't believe it at first. I thought it was just a prank or something. No, it was real. It was really sad since I had strong emotions for her the whole time. But she didn't feel the same anymore. After being together for over a year. Fine then, I guess. We were still friends. Moving on with my life though, we talked less and less and became more distant from each other. Talking to her was a bit of a pain. My family strongly advised I block her and forget about her. Man, I would have listened if I had knew what kind of monster roamed inside of her. Over the summer, not much else happened that I recall. I just vividly remember the summer nights of staying up until 4 or 5 in the morning with Zuzu and Leo, as well as whoever else stayed with us for as long as they could, just playing Fortnite, Minecraft, some other game, or just vibing in general. Those nights were hella fun, and with the time staying up, I'll never forget them. It wasn't just that, but most of the summer I was gaming with the boys all day, and then gaming with Zuzu all night, and then repeat. I still got my sleep though, no worries. I had my limit until like 6 a.m. at the latest. Even though most times I don't stay up that late, I usually just end up going to bed for like 3 or 4. So far I've never pulled an all-nighter, but I want like the perfect night to do that. And then it was June, and ooh, what's this? I was introduced to Kronos in Minecraft by Zuzu, and then I had showed it to the boys, and they introduced me to Egg Wars on CubeCraft. Egg Wars? What the f*** is Egg Wars? Hey guys, welcome back to My Strange Addiction, where I'm addicted to playing Egg Wars non-stop. Michael G and Michael S, aka Sullivan, had shown me it, and our first game was long, but we won. Michael G's egg defense was insane. Just endless obsidian and hay bales and glass on the egg. No one could get in. It grew so big because my first game had lasted over like half an hour and we ended up winning. I got hooked to Egg Wars since then. We played for countless hours. It's amazing. I've improved hell of a lot from the first game as well. I just remember editing like some old. I know I'm slow with editing, but when I was editing the one Egg Wars game with Zuzu, I was so bad. I almost, like, editing my old gameplay was cringe, because how could I be so bad at video games? Especially seeing how much better I am now. Then one average night, still in June, it was like 3 or 4 in the morning, I was about ready to go to bed. Just checking over retro server, looking through all the art in your creations channel, just real quick. Looking through before I was gonna head to bed. Oh, and then all of a sudden, someone I'd left a reply on saying the art looked cute had came into my DM saying a friendly hello and thanks for the compliment. Their name is Flambeau, and little did I know how much this dude would end up changing my life. After a bit of short talk, I had gone to sleep, and the next day and onward, we kept talking a lot on a daily basis. We get to know each other even better and build a stronger friendship. I've helped this man through a lot of tough times, and without me, I'm not sure where the poor guy would be now. But anyways, as time went on, our friendship was building, and so had the relationship with Creation Crew. The summer had been a rocking good time. August had come by now, and summer was closing for a finish. I was dreading going back to school a bit, but knew it was going to be inevitable. Everything was going great, but then, 6th of August, something really dumb happened. Anna. I used to be fine with her. I was still at least friends with her, despite still feeling a bit sad about the breakup from months ago. But now, I learned something just pure evil, and I still won't forgive her to this day. I was playing Egg Wars once again with the boys. When all of a sudden, Hannah had texted me to follow this person back on TikTok by the username Baka. I learned that this person is currently dating Max in a poly relationship, apparently. And came to me in some form of argument saying not to hit her again and stuff like that. I was confused, and after a bit of talking with the Baka person, I found out Hannah apparently told her, and God knows who else, that I apparently, quote, hit her and kissed her without consent, end quote. Everyone that knows me knows I'm super sweet and kind. Knowing full well I would never do something like that. I wanted answers, and I went to Anna's messages to try and get them. But, plot twist, she apparently blocked me, and on TikTok as well. Now I was furious. I was pissed off and super angry. She apparently was telling people false things about me, and then when I found out, she blocked me. So I made a temporary TikTok post, which I had later taken down about a week after, because I didn't think there was a point in keeping it up, but basically, I called her out with what she had done, and I let out some emotion I had for now, calling her some names and disproving the lies she said I had done. Also questioning why she would ever do this to me when I'd only treated her with kindness and love. And not to mention, I would literally sit on the phone with her for hours listening to her vent and rant about whatever was going on in my life. It was while we were dating, and even while we were friends, I would sit on the phone with her for at least an hour to talk to me about a lot of stuff. All of that, and then she does this to me. Then a few hours later, after I had made that TikTok, she shockingly unblocked me. Then again, I guess it's not much of a shock. And then we argued in the comments of that video for a while. I kinda wish I had the TikTok up, or at least took screenshots of the conversations to prove I'm about to say next, but I mean, you'll just have to take my word. But basically, after a lot of arguing and drama, I reached a conclusion of why she accused me of hitting her and kissing her without consent. She said it herself, and it was pretty unbelievable. Quote, because one time I was leaving your house, you pat my shoulder too hard and it hurt, end quote. I was left speechless at that, because it's just a touch. It's not like I pushed her down the stairs or physically abused her. Just a pat on the shoulder. And as for the kissing part, apparently, she said it was before summer break during hybrid school when we had our masks down, which I countered telling her we both agreed to do that before getting on the bus. I clearly remember asking for consent to do that, which is why we had done it in the first place, so I don't know why she lied saying it was without consent. And one of the last things she had said to me before blocking me again is that I didn't love her and I only used her for her body anyways. Yeah, okay, says the person who broke up with me because he didn't have feelings for me anymore, and in the start of our relationship he wouldn't shut up about, oh, if you ever break up with me, I will be depressed and kill myself. Just saying that for attention, okay. I went a bit too far with that whole thing, but I barely scratched the surface of this iceberg. There's more stuff, but I should move on now. I was going a bit too deep with that. It's just unbelievable to me how someone could be like that. Anyways, rolling into September, I was happy to see a very old friend in school I hadn't seen forever. I haven't seen this man since 9th grade. His name is Chris, and after September, nothing much else significant had happened, honestly. His last few months, I've been on a grind trying to get content up and draw stuff, as well as build even stronger relationships with the friends I have and let them know how grateful I am to have them in my life. I said 2020 was my last year to go trick-or-treating, but yeah, no, what the hell. I went again this year. I'm only 16. I'm not that old. In November and December, mostly have just been months of reflection for me. Those last 2 months, honestly, they felt like they just zipped right by. History class assigned us a huge argument project on October 3rd, and next thing I know, it's December, just inches away from the due date, and winter break. Then after school finally ended, we're on break. Nothing much else happened, just a lot of gaming. Then on New Year's Day, my family had gone to the largest water park in the nation, apparently. I think it was called Kalahari, but I forget. And then it closed at 6 and we went back home. And that was kind of about it. New Year's didn't really feel so celebratory since. What changed, really, other than the year? COVID's still around. This is 2020, season 3. We're just living another cycle of this all over again. When will it end? I don't know. But I guess the only thing that really has changed is that this is now a new chapter of my life. With the year ending and that chapter of my life coming to a close, I'd like to say goodbye 2021. And thank you for the fun memories. Even though this year had a lot of ups and downs, I still enjoyed it. So much had happened and so much had changed in my life this year. So now, we send off 2021 and see if 2022 gets any better. Oh wait, did I say 2022? No, yeah, I meant 2020 season 3.
Oh my god!
Oh! Aries! Oh. What are you? You're not toad. Get out. You're a skip. Among Us is very sus right now. All this map is absolutely non-mobile.
Why the heck does everything look like an Among Us? Everything looks like Among Us, dude. Why? Am I just surrounded by red?
Man, what the fuck?
According to this game, 30 years old. Hold
up!
No, please, please.
It's you!
You want such a fuck?
I want
a soda can!
The guy that looks like a sock!
Oh, Snapdragon! Whoa! Whoa! Oh, that sucks!
I wonder who
is the guy here?
Oh my god, let's go!
Doing record test? You're just going down low.
No, I mean like 10 seconds ago.
I'm going to stab! What?
Oh my god.
Oh, Diane!
The strategy!
So it
wasn't black? The fuck?
Sabotage, then you guys had it.
So,
I'm gonna say not red for the DCP button.
Evan didn't clear just one! He cleared
the
imposter!
And you
know
what?
I don't see red
twice
in this.
Okay.
Evan, give me a block.
That's not supposed to be blocked. What would you do? You better fucking run over.
No!
Why are you running? Why are you running?
What the f?
You're not believing me!
God damn it! How would it be me? Why would I self-destruct kill like that?
I have too much on him.
Oh. Okay, bad.
Yeah, bad. You want to say something to me, Evan?
I think I just lost because I know I had a suit on. Wow.
I still think he's playing us.
Did we finally get it?
Oh, I thought we had to get one more kill after that.
That was it!
No, Jeff Sanz is
little bridge thing instead of,
Jeff Sanz is 1.3.
Hey! That was nice!
Get over here!
What the f*** was that?
My bad.
Have you ever just wanted to murder a child for existing?
Get the f*** out of my way! Don't give
a f***! I was Chase!
No.
Get in the voice!
I'm done.
Thanks.
Get in the voice!
Yeah. I can tell now. It sounds like you're
falling down the stairs. Yeah, he's...
What the freak?
Barely, Michael. See, you're the only one who would say that, because you're gay.
What?
Twitch. Just type slow, Luna! Just type slow!
What player? Evan! I don't want! No!
No!
I'm stuck in the car! Wait, Evan, look at the car! Wait, Evan, I'm in the car!
What happened to the car? What the f***?
What have you done?
Wait, Michael, come back! Michael, come back! I am the fire.
There we go. Let's go. Surprise, motherfucker!
Surprised me. No!
Oh my god. That was hilarious.
So hilarious. I really have been trying to get the egg the whole damn time we were there, and you were just sitting there smacking them into me the whole damn time!
Yeah, they're.
Evan, help! You're just... Oh my god.
I took 2 seconds to eat. Why are you complaining? Why are you complaining?
Because
he doesn't have an egg!
You let him hit me in the void!
Ha ha!
What the f-
Oh wait, that's not Evan. Wait, that's looking that. Wait, I'm on orange.
Wait.
Wait. No, I was like, why did Evan kill me?
No! Fuck.
Oh,
okay. So, what are you doing here, Simon? Well, thanks, I guess. Off I go. I have better skill. That's why I thought I was so desperate to escape. Oh, hi. Yes. James!
I did something.
He's gonna break it!
It's all because you didn't decide.
You
fuck! Oh wow, this is... Evan! I wonder how we'll ever get into the egg!
They didn't fix it!
I wonder how we'll ever get into the egg!
Bro, that's how close I got, but wow, they never fixed it, okay.
had so much time.